This is Ash, and a warm welcome to my latest model train review video to come of 2020. And today we're going to be reviewing the Jouef TGV Uigo Duplex train set. And this one is part of the Hornby-Jouef range and was a 2019 release. And to be honest with yous, I got this one for an absolute bargain, as it is a complete four car train set and it comes with a controller, oval of track and everything. This is quite a heavy box and it is much bigger than the Hornby stuff, so what I'm going to have to do, I'm just going to turn this around just so I can get the reference number. And here we go, the details are as follows. This one is the reference number is HJ1042 and it's just above the barcode there. This is one of the Hornby Hobbies products, as they purchase Jouef Electrotrain, Lemur and Riva Rossi in 2004. I'm just going to put that back there, as what I'm going to do, the next part of this video will be, of course, the unboxing. But what I'm going to have to do, I'm going to have to figure out a way of getting this out of the box on camera, as it is quite a big box and I don't have too much room to manoeuvre about. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to place this camera, the box on the floor and adjust the camera accordingly. As a result, I decided to cover the Jouef version, as then you could always compare my video of this train set to Sam's video of the Mahano version of this train, okay? Right folks, it's very straightforward. This flap just comes out like so, and everything is presented to you in a tray. I'm not entirely sure if this train is DCC ready or not, as there is absolutely no information. What you just heard dropped on the floor is the track mat layout, of which is just this mat inside the plastic bag. So that's basically what you can do with this. If you're new to model railways, you can just pin this onto a 6-foot by 4-foot board and pin the track down and away you go. And basically with the series of track packs, of which I'm just going to bring the outer sleeve back into view of the box, basically the system is very much straightforward. It's very identical to the UK train sets, as all you need to do is just purchase these track packs accordingly and you can turn this into a very nice model railway for a good price, of course. Anyways, just going to move that out of the way again. We have covered the track mat, so we don't need to cover that anymore. This is your owner's manual, and this tells you how to maintain and look after your train set, and complete with some obvious information. As always, do look after my model trains anyway, so I don't really need to be told that, but that's just my opinion. Anyway folks, as I showed you on the box before, this just shows you the track packs on the back, and that's everything there is really to cover for the manuals. So I ain't going to really bother unpacking those, because I have covered those in another train set review that I've covered in the past. And likewise, I'll just bring this up to the camera. We've got the train, which is the fun part down here. We do have a re-railer, of which Hornby have thoughtfully put and have included in the train set, as these trains can be quite tricky to put onto the track with some train types. And I think the reason for this, they probably included one of these for those that are not too steady with their hands, and it does make life a lot easier when putting trains on the track and taking them off. So definitely good points there for Hornby in terms of putting thought into the design of their train sets. That's the re-rail done. Next thing to do is to cover the track. You get two single sections here, of which one is a feeder track, and that goes to the Hornby R8250. Although we're not going to be using the controller or the track from this train set, for the reasons being is that I'm going to do the test run on my test loop, as then we can go faster as the curves are more shallow, which gives the train more stability at higher speeds. I have tested the locomotive already, and it does work, and it does go quite fast. Of which, as we've covered the track, just to show the curved sections of track here, and if I just turn that around, these are your third radius of track, of which is the Hornby R609, and that is more than enough for the fine scale models that need a larger radius of curve. Okay, right, that's the track all covered. So the next thing to do is to take the locomotive, and this is your power car. Not too heavy, not too light, not quite as heavy as the premium models, and you can tell this is the low-end budget version, as these power cars do have the incorrect pantographs, so they just clip up and down like so. Although it wouldn't have hurt for Hornby-Jouef to have included prototypical pantographs, as it would have made the model look more convincing. But you could always replace these with the Lima versions, or more prototypical looking ones if you wanted to, as there is a provision of removing these toy looking ones and enhancing the model if you want to, which could be done. So that's the locomotive done. I will cover these in more depth on the turntable, but this is just the introduction and the unboxing of the train set, as I will cover close-ups and the 360 degree rotation. Okay, as I did cover that in the RENFE AVES100 in a previous review. We're now on to the carriage here, and disappointingly, as with the Mahano version, this Jouef version does not have an interior either. So unfortunately, the very basic detail, lack of interiors, is definitely going to cost this train set some serious points on this review. As I do try to be fair, but I'm a realist and I give honest feedback, and I do say what I see the way it is. So that's the first part done. And the second part to do is just to get this part of the train set out of the box, as this one is the other end car. And I'm not sure if Hornby-Jouef have issued any extra coaches for this train set, although it would have been grand if they did. But sadly folks, just to bring that to the camera and to just to prove a point, there is no interior in there at all, which is very sad. But this train set didn't cost me a lot of money, and it is good value, so I'm not going to expect too much really. But for the carriage itself, I think an interior would have been grand, as I'm disappointed to say that this model does not have working directional head or head and tail lights. And this one, of course, is the unpowered power car or locomotive, and the detail is very basic as per the motor unit, and the pantographs do adjust, but to be honest, that's really all there is really going for these power cars, to be honest. But anyways, that's the train set unboxed. The next part of the video to come is the close-ups, where I will show you more of the detail up and close, as then you can make your own judgments if you decide to get one of these train sets or not. And then it will be the rotation of each unit, as I like to be fair on my reviews. And then the final part will be the performance test, okay? It's now time to commence on with this part of the review, and this time is with the close-ups. We'll start from the front this time around, as we do have a very nice livery. This one is numbered as 760, and the livery is very, very striking in my opinion. I do like the OUIGO livery on the Jouef version. Unlike the Mahano version that was covered by my buddy Sam, this one hasn't got the glossy finish, which is grand, and the headlights are glazed, although sadly there is no working headlights on this model. But that said, I assume it wouldn't be too difficult to install a lighting kit just to make the headlights work. And the same thing applies with the central headlight above the cab window. The cab windows are tinted. There is a valid reason for this, and that is there is no cab interior. So that's the reason for Hornby to do full tinted glazing, as that helps keep the production cost down. The application of the livery does look very good. There is no blurring or smearing of the paint, which I did notice on the Mahano model that was covered by Sam, of which the review of that is on Sam's Trains, and I will post a link to his review on that train, as I won't be covering that train set on this channel, as I try not to duplicate other popular channels if I can help it. Although if I do like the train, I will do my own version of the review anyways. But as you may know, from now on, I will be covering European, Japanese and American trains. Although I will be covering the American trains in possibly 2021. As by the time this video goes live on the channel, it will be December 2020. And we will be getting closer to Christmas, so if you're looking for a nice, cheap, modern train set that has a high-speed train that is well-known, I'd recommend going for one of the TGV trains, if that would be your interest. But anyways, I'm just going to raise these pantographs, folks, as then I can just show them in the raised position. Just to make sure that I thoroughly cover everything. Sadly, they're definitely not the highest quality, as they're very much the same pantograph, just applied back and front. But in the real world on these trains, and I assume on the premium version of the Jouef TGVs, the AC and the DC pantographs would be correctly represented. But as this is a very cheap basic train set, the pantographs are very generic and there isn't really much to say on them at all. They're definitely not metal, although you could always swap these for better detailed versions if you wanted to. But apart from that, that's all there is really to cover on the close-ups for the motor unit. And the next thing to do is for me to cover the next part. This is the second part of the four car train pack that comes with this train set, of course. And just like with the Mahano version, as I did say in the unboxing section of this video, there is no detailed interior, of which sadly will cost this train set some points. But I do understand this to a point, as it does keep the production costs down. But hopefully Jouef will make a premium version of this train in the future, as it would be grand if I could get the premium model, of which would allow me to make the full 8-car train. Although the carriages do have semi-etched grills, although the detailing is very, very basic, the texturing is very grand, as it's not glossy, unlike the Mahano version, and all the detail on the doors, etc., is definitely there. And we can just see the destination blind next to the passenger door. And there is the details of the fleet number and the ID codes for the carriages as well. And we do have a very basic coupling on this part of the train, of which is just a lug and hook. And again, this is different to the premium model, as this is designed to keep the production costs down. But for £80 UK sterling, of which this what the price of this train set was, although some of them are selling for £120 sterling as well, that I have seen on the internet, so it does pay to shop around. But that's it, folks. There isn't really much else to cover on this carriage, and the reason for that is that it's very basic for detail, and the next thing to do for me is to cover the second carriage. We're now on to the second part of the carriages, as this one is the other one that comes with a train set. As you can see there, a very basic clip together hook tight coupler. And I would like to mention as well is that all the carriages and the unpowered locomotive all have plastic wheels. So again, that's another point that will be knocked off the final score for this train set. As to be honest, I would have liked it if this train set had had working head and tail lights, as that would make this train set more fun to operate straight from the box. But anyway, folks, just to carry on with the close-ups, there is the molded plastic catenary connections and the high voltage transfer cable from the locomotive at the back to the front is represented, although the detail is very, very basic. Sadly, there is no interior. So again, it is a bit of a disappointment not to have interiors. Although the air conditioning grills, of which I'm assuming these grills on the sides are for, they are picked out on the tooling rather than printed. So that's grand. And there's some other detail as well. The texturing is very grand, as there is no blur or fuzzy edging on the livery, unlike on the Mahano version. And this is the articulated end, and that will just clip into the other carriage, of which will be shown coupled together when we move on to the test run, or the performance test as I now call it. Anyways, that's the second carriage covered, and I'll just briefly go over the locomotive with the pantographs closest to the camera, just like I covered the AVES 100, as I do like to be thorough on my reviews. Okay then folks, we're now on to the final part of this close-ups part of the review, and we'll start off with the pantographs. Just as with the motor car, that is the powered locomotive, the pantographs are very basic and they're just duplicated on both ends, and that's done just to keep the cost down. The livery is well applied, as there is no fuzziness or paint bleed onto parts where the blue or the black should not go. Although, just like with the carriages, folks, the couplings are very basic, and that would make this train incompatible with the premium carriages, as they use a different coupling system altogether. The livery is well applied. The grills are etched as far as I know, and as far as I can tell from organic observation of the model. And this one is also numbered as 760 as well, as that will capture the actual train that it's based on, complete with the WEGO logo on the back as well, of which that translates into English as YESGO. Okay, anyway folks, that is the close-ups covered. The next thing to do for me is to cover each component with a brief 360 rotation, as to be honest, there isn't really much detail on these basic models to cover, but I'd like to make sure to be thorough on my reviews, so I will continue as normal, as then that will leave you to decide for yourself if to get this train set or not. Okay? It's now time to commence with a 360 degree rotation. And before we make a start, I'm just going to zoom out quite far just to make sure that we get the whole train still in the filming zone. And without further ado, as I'm looking forward to doing the performance test of this train set, of which will just be the four units on the Kato test track, as it will be interesting to see how good the performance will be, considering that this is just the only powered axles here and here, as these wheels are not driven. But it is a very basic model, so I'm not going to expect too much from it in terms of the performance, but we'll see how it goes anyways. Likewise, that is the powered part of the train, that is the locomotive, and I will place this on the test track, and it's time to move on to the first carriage. It's now time to commence on with this rotation of the first carriage of the two, and without further ado, let's just zoom out a wee bit just to make sure we get everything in the filming zone, and we can start with the rotation. Likewise, I'm just going to have to pan the camera around just to keep everything in the filming zone, as this carriage is quite long, just like with the AVS 100. This part of the carriage does have the articulated end, although as you can see there, I'm just going to zoom in and show you the wheels. Very basic looking, cheap plastic quality. Definitely not premium by any means. As well, I think the Mahano model that was covered by Sam does have metal wheels. Although you would have to see his review on the model train set that he has covered, if you haven't already done so, and it would be good to watch the two videos, as then you can do a comparison for yourself. Although I will be covering a Mahano train set, but it won't be of the same TGV, okay? But it will be a TGV. That's all I'm going to tell you is for now, okay? For the reasons being is that it is a certain TGV that I like, and I've been meaning to review one of those for a while, so that's something to look forward to on the channel. Anyways, sticking on topic without going too far off topic, it's now time to cover the second carriage as we get closer to the fun part, of which will be the test run. This is the second carriage that comes in the train set, and I shall just repeat the same process as I did with the first carriage. As to be honest with you folks, there is not a lot of detail, although the livery is applied better on the Jouef model when compared to the Mahano version. I'm just going to move this carriage a bit more to the left very carefully, just to avoid scratching the base. But likewise, as then I can cover this rotation easier without the need to adjust the camera too much, and as you can probably see, the detail very much speaks for itself. And that's all there is really to cover for this review. So that's the two carriages done. I will cover the unpowered locomotive, and then we can move on to the fun part, and that will be the performance test. This is the final part of the 360 degree rotation, and I'm just going to zoom out swiftly, as then we can commence on with this part of the review and move on to the more fun part, of which personally I'm looking forward to, as it will be interesting to see how the handling and the performance of this model train will be. But in terms of detail and the quality, it's definitely not going to get top marks. That's what I can say from the close-up observations of this model train. But anyways, just going to finish off this rotation. Although the livery and the logos are nicely applied, sadly there is no working head or tail lights on either power car, and there is no cab interior or prototypical pantographs. Even if they were in plastic such as these basic ones, it would have made the train look a lot better. And if this train set version of the TGV Duplex had used the same couplings as the premium models, that would have allowed compatibility between the premium carriages and just this four car set. So sadly, poor planning has gone into this model in terms of the couplings and compatibility, but the livery is very nicely applied. But that is the end of the rotations, folks. The next thing to do is to move on to the performance test, okay? Right, folks, it's now time to commence on in this part of the review. In this section, it's the performance test. As usual, what I'm going to do, I'm just going to reach over and start up the background train, of which is the Riva Rossi CC72000. Okay, and without further ado, as that train is quite fast, I have cleaned both tracks. Let's see how the performance goes on this Jouef OUIGO train set TGV Duplex. Just currently engaging on 25% power, of which is my Kato Unitrack controller. Increasing the power to 30%, increasing the power to 35%, increasing the power to 40%, of which I will leave it at this power setting. Correction, I'll leave it at this power setting. And what I'm going to now do is increasing that to 45% power, and then up to the maximum for this test run, and that is 50% power for this four car train. I'm just going to increase the power on the freight train just a wee bit more, as it is going a bit slow. I'm just going to decrease the power on the TGV OUIGO Duplex to about 40 to 45% power, as it is going quite fast. But as you can see, folks, there is no head and tail lights on this model, not even basic headlights for that matter. But to be fair, there is no headlights or tail lights on the Mahano model either, as that train set has been reviewed by Sam's Trains, and it will be worth looking at his video just to do a comparison of the two train sets. Likewise, it is quite a fast train, even at 40% power. So I'll just decrease that a wee bit more, because we're now on 35% power. The speed's very good. I'd only imagine that if this was running at full power, you would need a lot more shallow curves than this track would allow, as on tight corners This train at high speed or full power would easily derail. And to be honest folks, the train itself is quite lightweight and there is only two powered axles on the entire train. There is no all-wheel drive. So what I'm going to do, I will allow a few more passes just to see how the performance goes as the train is running more. As I've run this straight out of the box, I just did a wee brief test before doing this review just to make sure that everything is working as it should do. But likewise folks, I'm not sure if the microphone is picking this up, but you can hear a bit of a groan from the mechanism as well. There is a bit of groaning from the transmission on the powered two axles. Performance isn't really that smooth, which I'm just going to demonstrate here, as once you cut the power, there is a bit of a glide, but that is just the weight pushing the whole carriages and keeping the momentum going. There is no flywheel drive on this model either. But likewise, I just wanted to demonstrate that. Mechanically, the Mahano version, although it does have a glossier finish, if you're looking for performance, then perhaps the Mahano version would be the better one to go for, as both trucks are driven by a central can motor, albeit it's a three pole can motor. But there is an advantage for this Jouef model, believe it or not, and that is that the livery on this model is better quality. As the paint job is well made, the finish is grand, and it does represent the real train very well. Judging from the videos that I have seen of these trains on YouTube, okay? But the overscale pantographs is a bit of a letdown. What I'm going to do, I will give my full verdict and my comments on the overall quality and the overall rating at the end of this review. I will allow two more passes and then it will be time to adjust the camera to another position, okay? One more pass after this one, and then it'll be time to adjust the camera. This is just to verify that there is no working tail lights on the non-powered end of the train, which is a shame, as even this 18-year-old Riva Rossi model has basic directional head and tail lights. So here's a question for you. Do you think it's too much to ask of Hornby-Jouef to put directional lights into a basic train set like this? Personally, considering that Hornby put a lot of effort into the livery application, and I definitely have to say that for livery application, of the two models, this one is the best in terms of the quality of the livery. That, without a doubt, definitely applies to this model. But the model doesn't even have basic headlights, let alone tail lights. So my question is, would it be too much to ask for basic directional lighting on these model trains? For me, the answer is no, as LEDs are quite cheap nowadays, although I can always do this myself, and it's possibly something that I might do in the future, perhaps in the new year, once I have taken the model apart and find out of ways of how I can improve this model train, and that's if it can be done at all, as I will need to attach the LEDs to the light lenses somehow. But I think if this model had very basic directional headlights, I would love to give this train set a good score. But unfortunately, that's not looking too good at the end of this review. And what I'm going to do, folks, I'm going to lay a few more passes in this position, and then it will soon be time to wrap up this review. As you know, I like to be fair in my reviews, but I'm not going to say it's a cracking train set and it's really high quality if the truth is different, you know. Anyway, folks, two more passes and it'll soon be time to wrap up this review with my final score and verdict. And what I'm going to do for this train set is I'm going to give a breakdown of the reasons why this train set will lose points, of which is the reason why my final scores are always fair and justified. Anyway, folks, one more pass and then that will be time to start wrapping up this review. Okay? Right, folks, I think we've seen enough for the performance test, so it's therefore now time to start winding down this review, and it's now time for my overview and verdict, of which will be the reasons for the final score. The model train does run well and it does what it's intended to do. It is a very, very basic train set, as it does the job of providing entertainment, and you can always build on to the track pack, and compared to some of the UK Hornby train sets, Hornby-Jouef has included two extra straight sections of track, of which are the double straights, so you get a longer oval of track. The livery is very well applied, as it does look really crisp and high quality. However, those are the strengths for this model train set, I'm afraid. As to be honest, the train controller is certainly not one of the best, as some of those do tend to cause strain on the motor, which is the reason why I'm not using it. I'm just using my basic Caddo controller. The detail on the model train and the quality is not that great, to be honest. And I'm still debating on if to put, is this possibly one of the worst train set reviews that I've done? Although I'm certain there is a lot, there's many other train sets that are worse than this. But I'm not looking at the quality here in terms of the paint finish and stuff. I'm actually looking in terms of functionality, features and enjoyment. The positives for this model train, of which is the reason why I'm still calculating everything up for the final score. The paint job is good. The quality of the livery is there. There is no fuzz or paint bleed on the model. However, the negatives are for this train is that there is no saloon interiors on the carriages. There's no cab interior for the power cars. There's no all-wheel drive on the motor car. So that's 3 points off the final score already. The pantographs are not true to scale and they are very, very basic. And they are a bit flimsy as well. So that's another point lost on the final score. And the other points is that this train is possibly not DCC ready, although I have no idea to confirm that until I remove the body shell. The thinner decoder isn't going to be a problem for those that are happy to hardwire a decoder in, but the real letdown for this model train is that there is no head and tail lights. So factoring the account of the basic detail, no interiors in the carriages, no all-wheel drive and no directional lighting, I'm afraid folks, the maximum score I can give for this train set is 6 out of 10. Sadly, as much as I would love to give this a much higher score, I'm afraid the model train isn't the best for quality and finish apart from the livery application. As if it had prototypical looking pantographs, or more accurate looking pantographs and all-wheel drive, I would have given it a much higher score. And especially if the saloons had, for the carriages, had interiors, as then it'd be a lot easier to fit passengers and lighting into the carriages. Although there is third party interiors available, but basic saloon interiors and directional headlights for this model wouldn't have been too much to ask. So therefore, a 6 out of 10 is definitely a fair and a justified score. Anyway folks, it has been a long video, this one has, as there is more to cover. If you haven't already subscribed and you do enjoy my content, please do consider subscribing to this channel. And if you have enjoyed this video, please do give it a like, as that will help this video get more attention on YouTube. And the reason why I encourage people to subscribe to my channel is that I give honest, unbiased reviews and I just tell it the way it is, as I do not do bias reviews on here, okay? And I do believe in telling the truth about the product, even if it's not always a positive one. But until next time, Have a good week or weekend, folks. Thank you for watching this video. If you made it to the end, thanks again. Until next time, have a good week or weekend. Take care. All the best and God bless. I'm going to grab myself a cup of coffee as I'm getting a wee bit thirsty. Until next time, see you all later and stay tuned for another video coming soon, okay? Cheerio, folks, and all the best.